Hello students, today we will see first law of motion. First law of motion is also called as Newton's first law of motion. It is also called as law of inertia. It is also called as law of Galileo. Let us see what is the first law of motion. First law of motion says that every object will continue to be in the state of rest or to in the state of motion until some force acts on it. So we can see in our day-to-day life there are certain things like non-living things. If they are kept at certain place, they don't move from their place until some force acts on them. In our day-to-day life we see there are some things which are moving, and until and unless some force acts on them, they don't stop. So first law says that every object will continue to be in the state of rest or in the state of its motion until some force acts on it. For example, if you keep a book on the table, it remains in the state of rest until some force acts on it. There are various examples in which, for example, Earth is revolving around the sun. It is revolving around the sun because there is no force which is stopping its motion. So it is revolving continuously around the sun without stopping. But that doesn't happen on the Earth. When we roll a ball on the surface of certain object, on some certain surface, it comes to rest. This is not the violation of the first law. According to first law, every object will continue to be in the state of rest until some force acts on it. But when we roll an object on a ground or any plane surface, it eventually comes to end rest because force of friction acts on it. And as force of friction acts on it, the objects which are moving on the surface of the earth, they come to rest after some time. So first law of motion is also called as law of inertia. It is also called as Galileo's law. Then what is inertia? Inertia is tendency of an object to remain in the state of rest or in the state of its motion until some force acts on it. Or inertia is also defined as it is a tendency of an object to oppose. Inertia is defined as tendency to oppose any change in state of rest or motion or direction. So inertia is a tendency of an object to remain in the state of rest until some force acts on it. Inertia of motion is tendency of an object to remain in the state of motion till some force acts on it. Or tendency of an object to oppose any change in the motion is inertia of motion. Inertia of direction is tendency of an object to maintain the direction in which it is moving. Let us take example of inertia of rest. Suppose if you take a glass and if you keep a cardboard on it and if you keep a coin on it, if you tap this cardboard instantly or quickly, the coin falls into it. So what does this mean is coin wants to maintain its state of rest. The cardboard moves, but it tries to maintain its state of rest, and therefore it falls back into the glass because there is nothing to support it. Let us take some other example. Suppose if you are sitting on behind a scooter which is at rest, and suddenly the scooter starts to move, we fall backwards. Why is this so? Because our body wants to be in the state of rest, and suddenly the motion of car starts, so our body opposes the change in the state of rest and therefore it falls or it moves backwards. So these are some of the examples of inertia of rest. Inertia of motion. It is tendency of an object to oppose any change in the state of its motion. Let us take example. Suppose if you are traveling in a car or a bus, and the car and the bus, they are moving, and suddenly brakes are applied to you. And if suddenly brakes are applied to you, what happens? Our bodies or the passengers, they move forward. Why is this so? Because our body has, we are in the motion, the passengers are in the state of motion, and if suddenly brakes are applied, their body opposes that change. They oppose to come into the state of rest because they are in the state of motion, and therefore they fall forward or they lean in the forward direction. This is an example of inertia of motion. Let us take example of inertia of direction. Sometimes you know, when we are going through a curved path, if you are traveling in a car or in a bus, and if the car or bus takes a left turn, our body falls towards the right. And suppose if the car takes the right turn, our body leans towards the left. Why is this so? It is because our body wants to maintain the direction in which it is traveling, and it tries to oppose the change in the direction by leaning towards the opposite direction. For example, if the car wants to take a left turn, our body will try to oppose that change in the direction by leaning towards the right. If the car is traveling towards, if it is changing its direction towards the left, our body will oppose that change in the direction by falling towards the left. So once again, my friends, first law of motion is also called as a law of Galileo. It is called as law of inertia. And once again, inertia of three types: inertia of rest, inertia of motion, and inertia of direction. Now, my friends, inertia is the tendency of an object to oppose any change. And this inertia depends upon the mass of an object. More is the mass of the object, more is the inertia. Let us take an example. If I have a duster in my hand, if I have to move a duster in my hand from my hand, I require less force. But if I have to push a big truck, it is very difficult for me because the truck has more mass and it has more tendency to be in the state of rest, and therefore it has more inertia. More is the mass, more is the inertia, and we can say that mass is a measure of inertia. Thank you.